In Aaron Sorkin's original screenplay for The Social Network, the opening scene was supposed to end like this.
You're gonna go through life thinking that girls don't like you because you're a nerd. And I want you to know from the bottom of my heart that that won't be true. It'll be because you're an asshole.
Now, as a fan of Aaron Sorkin, it begs a question. Why didn't it? The needle drop is a difficult thing to get right. The song has to match the scene's tone, as well as that of the film as a whole. So let's look at it with the score instead. Enter Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross.
It'll be because you're an asshole.
Three reasons that David Fincher decided to use an original score instead of a song for that moment. Firstly, tone. David Fincher read the screenplay and saw a very different theme to the film than the one Sorkin had originally intended. A story that at its core is a young man desperate to elevate his social status, at any cost. The song had to therefore complement Mark's feelings of rejection and isolation when Erica delivered that line. The sinister quiet of the theme, accompanied by the stark, single-note piano, accomplished this much more effectively. Secondly, to use as a leitmotif...
When we met in January, I expressed my doubt...
The theme is reprised during the film. It's called back to Mark's feelings of being a social outsider, as he faces an interrogation by the opposing counsel in a deposition, alone. However, the final time the leitmotif is employed, he sits on the other side of the exclusion, as he's ripped up the existing social hierarchy.
0.03%.
The same theme is used, as although he has been victorious in a financial sense, it has come at the cost of his one true friendship, exacerbating his isolation. And thirdly, style. Ultimately, Fincher has a style, which he has honed throughout his filmography. Despite The Social Network having a much lighter subject matter than the majority of his other films, he still has a way of finding the darkness within it. And for that, he needed an original score that captured the themes of the film precisely. Reznor and Ross don't do a half bad job of it. So when is it best to use music, and when is it best to use the score? I'll only be looking at non-diegetic uses of music that the characters cannot hear, as they are most comparable to using a score. To do this, let's look at a filmmaker on the other end of the spectrum to Fincher, who uses existing songs throughout his films. Matthew Vaughn. Specifically, 2000's Snatch, which he produced. While Snatch was written and directed by Guy Ritchie, you can sense Vaughn's influence on the film, such as in its transitions, but especially in its use of music. Kick-Ass and Kingsman, which Vaughn went on to write and direct, also use existing songs as a key ingredient.
I'm kick-ass.
Snatch uses music in a variety of ways, such as for comedic effect.
There is a bookies I know that will take bets.
As a means of contrast.
Well, what is it?
And for irony. I'm coming, baby. I'm coming.
Bonjour.
But if we explore it further, we see that Vaughn uses music for the same reasons as Fincher. Snatch uses songs that match a scene tonally. This could be the music itself, such as this scene. It could also be the lyrics that match the scene the character is in. For example, one scene where Vinnie, Sol and Tyrone are paid to rob a betting shop, who unbeknownst to them belongs to a ruthless gangster, Bricktop. During the scene, the song Cross the Tracks, We Better Go Back can be heard, along with the repeating lyric, You Ought to Get Right Back. This signifies that they've crossed into a world of crime where they don't belong. The music itself also matches the group's hilarious ineptitude in this attempt.
Fish, what are you doing up there? What does it look like I'm doing up here?
As previously mentioned, Vaughn likes using existing songs to match the on-screen situation. One example from a film he went on to write and direct would be Kick-Ass's Baptism of Fire being accompanied by Omen by the Prodigy. Whilst he might make films of a lighter nature than David Fincher, giving him scope to use a wider array of music, he still uses it more than many other films of a similar tone. An example from Snatch is Diamond by Clint, playing during character introductions. The song feels perfect for the crime and caper story that is about to ensue. Also, the title of the song matches the central thread of the story exactly, because it can't help but be a little bit meta. And sometimes, he needs no other reason than it just being a great song. He also uses songs as leitmotifs, such as this song playing when one of the characters
is, that Bars?
Is visible on screen. The way the editor fades the song in and out as he opens and shuts the door subconsciously ties a thread for the audience between that music and that character.
I certainly told him, Tommy.
To talk about Snatcher's best use of music, I'll have to spoil a major part of the movie. So if you haven't seen it, go watch it. It's on the UK Netflix right now. And if you're not from the UK, get a VPN just to watch it. Which brings us to the sponsor. Just kidding. Throughout the final boxing match of the movie, Oasis's Something in the Bushes plays. The song cuts out when it looks like the fight might be over. And cuts back in as it resumes. Bricktop, the main antagonist of the film, has hired Turkish Tommy and Mickey to throw the fight, as he has a large sum of money bet on Mickey being knocked out in the fourth round. The scene where Mickey is distraught at the sight of a burning caravan is because his mother was in there. This was the doing of Bricktop, who threatens a similar outcome to the rest of his caravan site if Mickey doesn't do as he is told.
Not when they're putting out the flames on their children's backs.
So when Mickey gets back up from the canvas and knocks his opponent out cold, what song starts playing in the back room? The same song that was playing when Mickey was staring at the flames of his mum's caravan. This makes the audience realise, perhaps without them even noticing, that Mickey has not quelled the desire for revenge that burned inside him at that moment. It means that everything that has happened since, and is about to happen, can be traced back to then. This is done through the use of the leitmotif, without having to explain anything to the audience. And when Mickey's revenge begins to take shape, with his gang murdering Bricktop's henchmen, the music that was playing during the boxing match begins again.
It's quite a fucking thing.
This shows that this was a real fight that was taking place outside the ring between Mickey and Bricktop, and Mickey was about to land the final punch. Therefore, why wouldn't Love of the Common People have worked in The Social Network? It was completely out of place thematically, even in an ironic sense. In order to use a song as a leitmotif, it needs to match the whole film tonally. And not only did it not match the opening scene, it didn't fit in anywhere else either. It may be Sorkin style, but it didn't fit Fincher's. And like it or not, the director has the final say. In conclusion, there is no real right answer to when a score should be used and when an existing song should be used. It comes down to the style of the filmmaker. But it has to be the right song, and that's more difficult to get right than hiring professional composers to create a score made specifically for the film. Music, like any other part of the film, needs to have a real purpose behind it that builds on the story it accompanies. In the end, Aaron Sorkin got his wish in The Social Network. At the close of the film, whilst Mark is awaiting the response to a friend request he has sent to Erica, Baby You're a Rich Man by the Beatles plays. The song fits the scene. On the surface, the lyrics obviously relate to the character's current state. He is now a billionaire. However, the song also hints at greed and a disdain for the hoarding of material wealth, which again fits the character and the tone of the film. Regrettably, however, this song, Aaron Sorkin didn't write into the screenplay.